Hello everyone, welcome to my new video, US taxes and forms. Which forms to fill, which taxes to pay, and when to pay them when you have an LLC, both disregarded LLC or elected as a C-Corp. Again, it's not fun information, but you have to know it because you want to afford you will get a fine. Well, my name is Juan Born. I'm the founder of the European Self-Publishers Group. In this group, I help people to overcome obstacles like taxes, like selling out companies, so they can have more success in the publishing business. Let's dive into it today. Disclaimer, this video is not created to replace proper legal advice. I'm not a lawyer. I'm not a CPA in the US. I don't have a degree in those things, so keep this information as an information so you don't forget to do stuff. I do my best, but I'm not a lawyer. So, US businesses and taxes in US regarding a disregarded entity. Like I told you guys in the previous video, a disregarded entity is not a solid solution to have a legal ACX account, so you should elect your LLC to be taxed as a C-Corp to become totally legit. But I know a lot of you have a disregarded entity. An LLC has a disregarded entity, so you have an AN number, but you didn't, but you don't pay taxes in the US because it's a disregarded entity. So what I've heard that you have to inform the IRS about how much you make and how much you, what your revenue was, what your costs were, and how much you made. This is just for information. You officially don't have to pay taxes. Someone of the group mentioned the form 1040 NR for non-residents. I have to dive into it. It looks like that is a form to pay taxes, but I have to dive into it further. I'm not sure what kind of setup that person had that he has to file this form. So let me dive into it later. And important, even if you have a disregarded entity who doesn't pay tax to the IRS, the official taxes collection from taxes in the US, you, dependent on which state you founded your LLC, you might have to pay state taxes. So that's something you have to dive into. Later on this in February, I want to make a series of videos about all these forms, about all these state taxes, and to help you guys as much as I can. These videos will be sent out by email, so you will get a private link to a YouTube video which is only available for people who have the link, and then you sure you don't miss out any videos. Some of them will be published on Facebook, some of them will not. So, US business taxes for an LLC tax as a C-Corp, the proper solution to have a legal ACX account. So it's a legal person slash entity in the US, so you have to pay taxes to the US government, and you have to file it to the IRS through form 5472 before March 15th. So as said, I will make a video about it. I didn't have filed them yet because I still have to do my latest updates to my bookkeeping, and then I will contact my CPA and then we can file it, and then I can help you guys better and more. And of course you might have to pay state tax. How much and when depends on the state where you have founded your LLC. I will make a video about it with the most popular states and when, how much, and where to file it. I'm currently, my business resides in Wyoming, and there they have the state tax you have to pay 1 year after the foundation. So for me, it will be November 1st, 2020. So until then, I'm still safe regarding state tax, but I will keep you guys informed as soon as possible. So, big questions always. Do I have to pay tax in both countries? And they say, oh, then if I found an LLC, then I have to pay tax and in Italy and in the US, or and in France and the US. Yes and no. You have to pay taxes in both countries, one where you have your legal business entity and one where you reside and where you receive the money. But most Western European countries have tax treaties with the US to avoid double taxation. So I have an example here on the screen. Let's say you have to pay 21% tax in the US and 40% tax in Spain. I think it's 25% in the US with an LLC, Texas C Corp. So, and you make $100,000 in 2020, then you have to pay $21,000 tax in the US, but you can deduct this from your tax in Spain. So in Spain, you only pay $19,000, the remaining $19,000. So at the end, there isn't a big difference if you would reside in Spain only, because if you would receive the money in Spain, you would pay about 40 grand anyway, and now it's only divided in two countries. Of course, you have to pay the state tax, which is a little bit extra, but you can also deduct it. And the only double cost is that you might have to have two accountants instead of one, one in the US and one in your local country. So that's the only extra costs. But yeah, if you can make $100,000 in ACX, I think it's worth it. It's better than working for your day job. So I hope this video helps. Again, there are a lot of forms. A lot of forms I have to still investigate and dive deep into. I was a little blocked this week because I had too much things to do at the end. I didn't make any video. I already got a lot of information for you, but I decided to give myself all month of February to make in-depth videos about all these forms, about all the different tax setups you have to help you guys out. And what's the catch? Well, there is no catch. The only thing, if I believe in that, if I help you guys were also willing to help me. You can help me by buying, by setting up your LLC through one of my affiliate links, which I will provide in the next videos. And of course, you can order books with the Urban Writers using my code Juan, my name, to get a 5% discount. And I heard some people talk about a 10% discount, but that doesn't exist. Percent discount. Mac has a 5% discount, Twins have a 5% discount, and I have a 5% discount. So there isn't any 10% discount with Urban Writers, as far as I know. And I saw Natasha confirming this. So it would be great if you can also help me out and to motivate me to make these videos, because they're not fun, but they're necessary, not only for me, but also for you. So hope to see you fast in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe below to receive an email when I finished every video. You won't regret it. It will help you and it will save you a lot of time in figuring out stuff yourself. And even if you have a CPA, you can ask your CPA, what about this form, what about this form, etc., etc. And then you're more sure that you don't miss anything and that you do everything correctly as you should do. Okay, that's enough for today. Hope to see you in the next video soon. Bye now.